New tonight, the roads are now open. Big Sur residents can now move back and forth. It is one step forward, one of many steps they will have to take in the Big Sur community to recover from this Pfeiffer fire. Action News reporter Jacqueline Mazur is live in Monterey with more on today's developments. Jacqueline?
Dan, as you said, steady progress is being made. Now, there were expectations that came out that maybe today the cause of the fire would be released and the exact location where that fire did in fact start. However, that is not the case. The Big Sur community, meantime, is sticking together. They are dealing with their loss one step at a time. Sycamore Canyon Road and Pfeiffer Canyon Road are now open. Landowners can come and go as they please.
Folks can actually, for the first time, get back and look at their properties and see the extent of the damage.
It's a chance for fire victims to sift through the ash and look for anything that may help them prove damages, but there's more to it than just that.
They want to have closure, and oftentimes there are things that could have survived the fire. You know, mementos, a little piece of something, a piece of their history, which is what I have lost, is my history, my childhood, and all that irreplaceable stuff is just gone.
But the community is sticking together through the worst. There's a free Christmas dinner scheduled at the Santa Lucia Mission Outdoor Chapel in Big Sur, right next door to the health center. Mass is at noon, followed by the feast at 1.
I'm hoping that a lot of people will come. I'm hoping that those in need will come.
Victim of the fire does have somewhere to go for Christmas and for the remainder of the holiday season. She does extend her thanks to all the community members who continue to help the residents of the Big Sur fire. Now, meantime, the next public meeting is scheduled for Thursday at 11:30 at the Big Sur fire station. Landowners who lost their homes are all encouraged to attend. Dan.
All right. Thank you, Jacqueline. Again, the investigation into the cause of the fire and the precise location where it began yet to be released. We will have that information as soon as it's available. Latest from the U.S. Forest Service says that all evacuations and road closures have been lifted. Fire crews were mopping up today and monitoring the area for any potential flare-ups. In all, 917 acres were burned. The cause remains under investigation. It broke out December 16th.